We have received Honorable Supreme Court's order. The order is being studied by our legal team, and we will decide about the future course of action on the advice of our legal team. As I mentioned, we are studying the Honorable Supreme Court's order, and after studying that, as per the direction of the court and as per the findings of our legal team, we will proceed. We will let you know about that only after getting the legal position clarified. Quarantine is not a police this thing. You know that very well. It is BMC. Decision is taken about it by BMC. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Of course, the Mumbai police wants to now do a head-on-head battle with the CBI after the Supreme Court verdict. Clearly,
it's going to continue under 174 of CRPC. Now, if I'm not mistaken, on one of the last pages of the 35-page order, the Supreme Court, in fact, had thought about this and even cautioned the Mumbai police for not holding a parallel investigation, saying that they must cooperate totally with the CBI. But here, this force seems to have some vested interest, Navika, in staying at some level or the other plugged into this investigation.
Absolutely. The Mumbai police, the Maharashtra government is showing its desperation to stay in this entire probe. In 65 days, they have not converted their inquest proceedings into an FIR, and now they say they will continue to investigate this entire issue under Section 174 of the IPC, and that really shows the desperation of the Maharashtra government.
That's the central question. Why is it that they're so scared? Why, like mother hens, are they guarding their turf? Even after the Supreme Court has said that you really don't have any locus standi left because you never really put your heart into this probe. Now, viewers, this is a very, very serious question. And this is really at the heart of the lost 65 days. For 65 days, the Mumbai police, and many people are saying, is being led by someone very powerful to bury, to destroy evidence.